Good morning, Mr. Seggos, Commissioner.
Senator.
Thanks for being here. Appreciate your input on this. Got a few issues I'd like to cover here. First, the budget calls for many deferrals of tax credits in a variety of areas. And the environmental conservation budget is not exempted from that. They're proposing to delay tax credits on brownfield projects, on electric vehicle charging stations, just to name a couple. How are we going to move forward with these programs without these credits? I know I have a great deal of concern, and I think a lot of my colleagues do, on the impact in general with these deferrals to New York State's credibility as a whole, whether it's to an economic development project or brownfield cleanup projects. We're hurting our credibility with these deferrals. We did it years ago with the Empire Zone program. Took a long time to recover from that. What's your reaction to that concern?
Well, I appreciate your input on that. So we obviously have to find a way to balance a significant budget. We have a budget deficit. And the thought on the deferrals is, while this is an issue with tax and finance, not specifically DEC, it obviously touches an important DEC program. The deferral is meant to be short-term in nature. Over a certain threshold, the tax credits that are attainable by the developer will be deferred for 3 years. The brownfields tax credit pool as a percentage of the total pot of deferments is about 15%. So it is a significant number. And we have to find ways to reduce spending over these 3 years. I hear your point. We will ensure that we share that with Tax and Finance and the Division of Budget. But I'm not in any way concerned that the program itself isn't somehow weakened. We've done, thanks to your help and the help of this body, great work in reauthorizing the Brownfields Tax Credit Program. That's been running very successfully. The reforms have worked. I believe are working. We're seeing better numbers out of that. We certainly will continue that work on our end and look to address any of the concerns the legislature has on that.
So a project, a current brownfield project that's underway right now, the developer is going to have to wait 3 years to get their tax credits under this proposal, correct?
Only over the $2 million. So if the $2 million threshold, so if there are tax credits over $2 million, then they'd have to wait for those for 3 years for those particular credits. Everything under $2 million.
After that 3 years, when will they be paid out?
Paid out over, I believe it's a course of
three-year
period,
three-year period.
Yeah, 3 year period. So it's a 3 year wait and then a 3 year payout over $2 million.
And that's per taxpayer,
right?
Which oftentimes with the Brownfields program, it's LLCs who are participating. So it may not be an individual corporation, but it would be a number of taxpayers who that would be divided amongst. It's $2 million per taxpayer, is my understanding.
That's the threshold, $2 million per taxpayer. So if there's multiple individuals in an LLC,
if there's 10
individuals, it's a $20 million threshold?
I believe so, but we'd have to confirm that with Tax and Finance.
Okay. Yeah, could you get back to me on that, please?
Yeah.
With regards to the electrical vehicle chargers, the state put in a pretty aggressive program to install 10,000 chargers by 2020. We had a goal in the state to have 3,000 installed by the beginning of this year. It was 1,300 chargers short, nearly 50% short. How do we achieve our goals in this important area by deferring these credits that will further delay implementation of these charging stations.
Senator, I might ask you to raise that with NYSERDA. I am not as familiar with the details in that particular deferral.
Okay, I will do that. Next area I'd like to get into is the harmful algal blooms and the decision by the department and the administration to choose 12 lakes. Obviously, when you choose 12 lakes out of the many lakes that we have, there are many more lakes that are disgruntled and unhappy about not being chosen. Being a representative from the Finger Lakes, you know, we're very concerned about the work that's been ongoing by groups around every one of the lakes in regard to this. Cayuga Lake was chosen, Seneca Lake, Cuca Lake, Canandaigua Lake were not chosen. I know we had a conference on this a week ago, myself with Julie and Venetia from the governor's office. But I'm still unclear on how that selection process went. Why was one body of water chosen over another? Just Seneca, as an example, the largest of the Finger Lakes, has, you know, Seneca Lake Pure Waters Association has done tremendous work in this regard. There's a Finger Lakes Regional Watershed Alliance. There's a Finger Lakes Institute. There's a Federation of Lake Associations. You know, why was Seneca Lake left off of this?
Well, I want to disabuse you of the premise that Seneca Lake was left off the radar screen, okay? The governor came up with this very ambitious plan to dedicate enhanced resources to 12 priority water bodies. And what we tried to do in selecting these 12 water bodies was look regionally and try to pick 12 that are in some way, shape, or form different from one another, because providing a long-term solution to those 12 lakes inherently requires us to go out and do science, enhanced testing of the lakes, watershed characterization, and develop almost a type of lake with the types of problems that impact it, and determine how those kinds of problems are creating blooms on lake. Every single lake, as we have found, there's about 150 lakes in New York State, lakes and rivers, that have been impacted by algal blooms. They're all different in a way. There's some different causes. Some are in nutrient-rich watersheds. Some have been whacked by massive storms, like last summer on the Skinny Atlas Lake. Several lakes, we would fear for them becoming impacted by halves, like Lake George. So we try to take representative samples of types of lakes, apply enhanced science, and do some sort of no-regrets spending on those lakes to fix problems. While at the same, and that's the $65 million proposal, while at the same time remaining as aggressive as we have been on all of the other lakes that have had problems, including in particular the Finger Lakes, the ones you mentioned. We have created a couple years ago, right after I started, the Finger Lakes Water Hub, which we launched specifically because of the HABS problem that looks at all of the Finger Lakes all at once. We have enhanced monitoring now going on in all the Finger Lakes as a result of that. We're boosting monitoring stations, and we're helping community groups on those lakes. You mentioned Seneca Lake Pure Waters Association. There are other community groups on other lakes, various land trusts. We're helping them get to the point of developing long-term plans if long-term plans don't exist, and also compete for funding. The Clean Water Infrastructure Act that you all helped us enact last year has given us resources that we never had. We've had the EPF, which has been very helpful. Clean Water Infrastructure Act in land on the land acquisition line is enabling us to spend money all across the state on waterways that are impacted, like the ones you mentioned. So I fully expect that work to continue aggressively. We will not be taking our eyes off the ball on Seneca Lake or Cayuga or any of the other ones that are impacted. And if something happens on those lakes, we will parachute in and attempt to fix the problems. And I will say that lakes that are impacted by HABS are probably going to be in a very good place to compete for the state funding that we have available. But we'll continue to work with your office on anything.
What was the source of that $65 million?
It's a combination of EPF and Clean Water Infrastructure Act funding.
And so the lakes that aren't, well, before I get to there, the 12 lakes that were that you're studying now, well, what's your timeline on process? When do you think you're going to be through this, at least the planning stage,
right,
and going to implement things and hopefully see some results of what's worked and what hasn't?
Well, it's funny you mentioned that. Right now, the governor is in New Paltz convening a HAB summit that I would otherwise be at, but for today's fun here in Albany.
You'd rather be there.
I would much rather be there, of course.
He, of course, would rather be here before you, Senator.
We're doing four HAB summits in a very short period of time. So the first one today, next one's in Syracuse, focusing on, that's the 5th and 6th, I believe, focusing on Finger Lakes. Then we go west, western New York, and then North Country. All of those summits are designed to bring actual experts to the table, not just talk, but experts to give us their perspectives on how to fix problems. Understanding that each lake is different, how do you fix the lake? We'll convene those summits, get expert reports done, and actually projects underway hopefully this year, this summer. So it's designed to be a fast process, and we want to be ready for the summer's HABs problems.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.